Google Sheets recently introduced a new feature called Sheets Smart Cleanup. With this feature, you get to do two things. Number one is it takes a look at your dataset and tries to find out if there could be any problems in that dataset. For example, are there any duplicates in that dataset? Is there anything that might be spelled incorrectly? So it gives you a chance to fix your dataset before you analyze it. And number two is that it can take a look at a column and give you these statistics based on that column. Okay, so we're gonna take a first look at these two features together. Let's jump in. First off, let's take a look at column statistics. So I have a sample data set here for division, region, app, and actual sales. And let's say I quickly want to get an idea of what's in the app column. I'm going to go to data, down here, select column stats. I get a new pop-up on the side, and the first view is the count of the different items I have in that column. So by looking at this, I can see that arcade is the app that occurs the most in this column. You can hover over each of these bars and you get the count of that item. If I scroll down, I get to see the frequency. So when I hover over these, I can see the items get highlighted in the column. So this is sorted by most. I can switch the view to least. Now notice something here. App, which is the title of my column, is included here. It's also included in the summary section under unique values. To make sure you exclude these, make sure you freeze the pane of the first row. So I'm just going to bring this down to freeze the pane. And now let me just close this and go back to column stats. So data, column stats, and it should disappear from my unique values, which it did, and also from the frequency list here. But for some reason, it doesn't disappear yet from the count. So I can see app still in the chart here. To switch and analyze another column, you can click on the arrows on top here. So when I click to view the next item, it jumps to actual sales. This time, because I have numbers, I get to also see the distribution of the data set. So when I hover over each of these columns, I can see the count of actual sales for numbers between 0 and 2,270. So I have 67 values that are between this threshold. Now you can just hover your mouse over the other columns to see the count for the different thresholds. Now on the bottom, you also get frequency, and under summary, because we have numbers, we get more information. So we get the sum, average, median, and so on. Now notice though, it says total rows is 972. This isn't the total rows of data, because if I jump to the bottom of this data set, I just have data that go until 137. So this is looking at the rows inside the entire column. If I jump all the way to the bottom, I have 973, right? So it's 972, it excludes the column header. For empty cells, it's also including all the empty cells that are below this column. Now, it would be nice to just restrict the view to the range where you have data, or if we could somehow specify the column range we want to analyze. I hope that's something that Google will add in the future, because it would be great to see the number of empty cells you have within the data set. Okay, so that's column stats. Now let's take a look at smart cleanup. But before we do that, just take a look to see if you're subscribed to this channel. And if you aren't, consider subscribing. Now let's take a look at smart cleanup. With smart cleanup, you get to clean up your data set before you report on it. This, of course, minimizes the number of errors you have in your end report. So let's see if there's anything we need to clean up here. I'm going to go to data, select cleanup suggestions. This immediately is going to pop up another window to the side here with any suggestions it might have for me to clean up the data. So here I can see I have duplicate rows here. Notice when I hover my mouse over a row on this side, it gets highlighted on my sheet. The green one is the row it's going to keep, And the red one is the row it wants to remove if I select remove. Now, of course, I can choose to ignore this if I want to keep it. In this case, I'm going to remove it. Now, in addition to this, it also found some records in the A and the C column, which I can see marked with this red exclamation mark, that needs some additional cleaning up. So here I need to trim white space because it looks like I have extra spaces after the word game. Now that's in cell A18, so let's just go and double check that. When I click inside the formula bar, I have these two extra spaces. To get rid of it, click on trim all. Now I have the same issue for button in the C column. So I'm going to click on trim all. That's going to clean everything up. I have no more exclamation marks here. And I get to review the column stats if I want. So this is going to take us back to the column stat window we saw before. And that's it. My data has been cleaned. But is that really it? Well, not really. Check this out. If I write a sum function here and I just want to sum up this and this, close bracket, what am I going to get? Well, not the right answer. I'm only getting back 6130. It doesn't see this as a number. Why? Because it has been formatted as text. Now, this is something I would want Smart Cleanup to recognize. If there is a number that's formatted as text in a column where everything else is number, it should detect that. That's going to save us from a lot of trouble down the line. So what I'm going to do is switch this now to a number, and now I can see my sum formula update correctly. Now, aside from this, there is another issue in this dataset. So for region here, when I scroll down, I have Europe, but here I have Europe typed incorrectly. I forgot the E at the end and it didn't pick this up. Now, I assume that this feature is going to get smarter the more and more we use it and the more patterns it starts to recognize. Now, there are cases where it does find inconsistent data. So, for example, if I switch to the names tab here, I have a list of countries. Let's go and run cleanup suggestions on this. I see inconsistent data, United States. A2 has United States, whereas A10 has United States. So I can apply this one to the rest. So I'm going to click on the check mark. And that's corrected. Aside from this, it didn't find anything else. But I have another problem here. I have United Kingdom and United Kingdom, but it didn't detect this. Okay, so this is the first look of Smart Cleanup and statistics. Now, of course, I assume that there will be a lot of improvements as these features are used more and more by us. Let me know what you think about this in the comments below. That's how Sheets Smart Cleanup works. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you're interested to learn more about Google Sheets or just improve your skills in terms of office productivity, take a look at the other videos and playlists that we have on this channel. Thank you for watching, and I'm going to see you in the next video.